All right, here we go. We're gonna here on Windchaser. Got our trucks all lined up in a row, kind of, sort of. Some trailers in here. Anyways, we're over here on the grain farm. Just built this. The drives are pretty fucking loud. We just were in our T9.565. Quad, or whatever you want to call it, dual wheel monster. Just expanding some fields. Just gonna hop in this because I don't feel like walking. Bought a field that wasn't a field, it was just land. And basically just built a field. Shut that off. So, this will be interesting. Park the tractor right in the door. Oh. Alright, well. Anyways, we got our 8360R with our DB 345 dry box spreader. Dirty skin. Needs a little bit of work. Whatever. So we're just going to hop on one of these. Currently filled with herbicide. We're just gonna take the back road. Taking the back road. So we got massive woods over here, the cattle farm over there. We got a lot of weeds to spray today. I want to plant some soybean and some corn. To really get my fertilizer tender trailer. Matter of fact, I think I'm going to. So we have our power lines running back here, some trees, some staging for manure, if you're into that kind of thing. Pretty cool farm over there. I think what we're gonna do later today is we're gonna get online. And make some MP videos of wood chipping and logging. Should probably set up my GPS here. Better look at the cattle farm. It's got some quite a few sheds, beet storage for sugar beets there over in the coverall building, grain storage. Well, pretty simple. I'll just see what I can do. I can get a new course here. Bump it over with my keyboard. That looks good. So this is the field that I went and plowed in. Reset the weeds, so the weeds kind of grow. Then I own... Let's see here. This is field 22. Need to spray 41, 40, 38, 39, 42, and 43. I'll lower this a little bit. And we're off. I noticed that when you spray a herbicide, it also fertilizes. So you pretty much just need sprayers. Because once you spray your weeds. Oh, no, this ain't gonna work. Messed it up. Need to load that one again. put that in. Move it over. Crazy driving. I love this sprayer, actually. What I did is, because it wouldn't go very fast, which was unrealistic, and the cutting area was really small, so I just expanded the cutting area out about a meter, or whatever I did, so you can actually take a turn, you know, corners without it skipping. And up the spray speed to something a little bit more realistic. So, I think this is what they call Miracle-Gro herbicide. Because you can spray, yet it fertilizes, so... I don't know. I really, really, really cannot wait for that soil management to come back to 15. So the last video I posted was just me cultivating up this ground, just some dirt. So now this one's gonna be fertilizer, killing weeds. Budweiser plant. So this is just kind of an industrial park, so to speak. So it is, what time is it? 7 o'clock in the morning. So we get some pretty good sky views. So I'm at 50%. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go buy a fertilizer trailer, just so I don't have to be running back to the farm the whole time. Distracted. GPS. That's embarrassing. Whatever. Let's spray that stuff again. This field is about 2 or 3 meters too wide. 2 meters too wide. Otherwise it would have been perfect. For this spray. So on one tank, we can cover quite a bit of ground. I mean, I think this is a about a 60-acre field, roughly. Maybe 80-acre. I can't remember if it was 20 or 30 hectares. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead. Oop. And buy one of these. Oh, geez, I don't realize that's expensive. What I don't need, I really don't need. I don't really need that. And then I need. Yeah. I need a fast truck. So this is the other field I was talking about that needs to be sprayed. Yeah. These are the piggies. Piggies need to be fed. Staging for liquid manure right there. There's another big field we own, 33, roughly 75 hectares, I think, which is what is that, 140, probably close to 200 acres. Here's a bale cell location where you can sell straw, hay and straw bales and alfalfa. So I just put that in. Here's another cool field, 27. Geese flying by. So what we'll do is we'll putz on over, pick up our trailer, fill it up at CPS. We'll refurbish, replenish our tank on that sprayer. Holds sprayer could fill four times. Oh crap. Well, that's interesting. Set over here. I wonder why this isn't charging me any money. Not that I'm complaining, but... And weird. Dang it. One's for herbicide, one's for fertilizer. Whatever. Rookie mistake. So many trees ready to get harvested. Thank you. So, this map, extremely detailed, but extremely well built by me. 60 frames per second everywhere. You can see the pull on my GPU anywhere from 50 to 60% to hold 60 frames per second. Even looking at all the details, clip distance, you know, pretty easy to 24-inch monitor, all ultra-high graphics, everything's high, so I mean, pretty easy. Runs smooth. So we're pretty much done with this field. It didn't take very long. I'll cut this movie short and plant some soybeans here for you guys, and maybe I could do sugar. What do I need? Okay, so we're gonna be doing some crop farm. So why not? This wasn't that expensive of a field. We could probably. Get some nice soybeans out of here. Low yield though, so maybe corn. We can use corn. So, when calculating yields in this game, we are trying to calculate what the yields actually were. And the yields on this map are standard in-game, where it's like corn was like 700 bushels per acre. Wheat and barley were like 300 bushel an acre or something like that. So soybean on the map's around 75 bushel an acre, which is really high, but it doesn't seem that high in-game. Corn came out to be about 250 bushel an acre corn, which is pretty realistic. I mean, a lot of dairy farmers, that's kind of what they yield. And wheat's a little over 100. Barley's flirting with like 90 to 100. Canola's down. Alfalfa is about 40% of that of grass, or 40% more than grass. And it's nice because you can fertilize it, so. I just love the engine sound. What, it only fills on one side? Is that... I don't get this. I don't understand what's going on. Huh, must be, have to be empty or something. Anyways, I'm just gonna putz on back, pick up, actually, I'll show you guys a little bit of this cattle farm quick. Because I actually have some beef cows. Alright, so we got some beef cows in here. We got some floating calves. How much manure do we have? Oh, that's right, you have to shovel it out. Well, how about liquid manure? 6,000! Cool. And here's the woods putting some new birch trees and some new paths. Like, you just like putz around in these woods all day. You can clear cut, you can selective cut, but I have birds chirping. Nice little paths coming through here. Busting out here. This is the silage mountain, 002. Two big heaps for your silage, so you could just build silage and feed your cows, or you can just do what we are doing on the dairy and keep your commodity shed filled. Silage, grass, straw, mixed rations. So and then their it's just your feedlots. Then you have more on this side of the road. This shed's a little bit smaller. Took the big brown one in Blender and just kind of took the back off and put in some rear windows. So that's all that is. But these all have you can feed these cows as well. Some stones where you can get sand, load up a trailer with sand and bring it to some sell points. So now that that's done, we can work our way back to the farm. This little back road is that brings you from the main road to the back side of this grain farm. It's pretty fun to drive on, I'm not gonna lie. Get some nice pictures. You got all the trees. Those trees, they can be cut, and then it just has grass in that little island there, so that it can be cultivated. So you can cut them down, grab the stumps, plow them, expand your fields, or remove obstacles, I guess. so that's that. I actually kind of want to plant with this. Try something different. I'm gonna use both with follow me mod, and we're just gonna destroy. So we don't waste time. Soybeans in this one. Since both of our quad tracks today. But go big, go home. Then we're going to try to tackle 42. Get some soybeans over here in 42. Offset of 21. So it's going to be a bit funky starting out, but once it gets its lines and everything, it should. To spray these weeds later. It'd be nice because we'll have a pretty large headland. So it won't be very difficult to turn around here at these end rows. Do the same thing with sprayers, so you can be running two sprayers. The only downside is when you're running and follow me, the implement never shuts off, it's always on. So as you can see, this is a pretty big field, and we'll make quick work with it. So I have him set up at the same working width, the offset as my working width, and you know how far behind, that just so he doesn't run into me really. putting down, we're planting and laying fertilizer at the same time. We just have to come with our sprayers and spray this field with for weeds. You can see it knocks it down, but it doesn't kill it. So it's knocking down these weeds, but they're still there. It's best to let the crop grow a few growth stages. And spray. You can see like how long we've been in this field already, and you know, compared to this map, there's a lot of ground to farm here. too far ahead of my follow me guy. Or he hit a tree. Oh yeah, got too far ahead of him. Gee dang it. That's easy enough to fix. I was getting a little too far ahead, but just wanted to push the envelope, see how far ahead I could go. Beautiful. That's a 565, and this is the T9 700, so this has a little bit more power, a little bit more torque than the tractor that's following it. So it's probably pulling this planter a little bit easier, because this planter is like a cultivator. It uses RPM and horsepower to power the planter, but it also has like a resistance force, like on a planter. So like if we were going uphill, the quad track would pull away pretty easily from the 565. But on this relatively flat ground, they keep pace pretty good. Both pull the Lemkin cultivator pretty easily, except uphill. So if you're farming more hilly fields, you have to use the contours or just approach it differently. Collision! So I'll probably spray these weeds after about two or three grow stages. Spray them on the third or fourth. Suffice to say, this field got pwned. All right, that was 42 in like 42 seconds. Let's go cruise on down to a 22 then. Actually, I'll probably cut it short. Been a long video. Bring it back to the complex. Thanks for watching.